மேல ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃப்ளோர்
நம்மளுடைய பத்திரிகை
செகண்ட் செகண்ட்
பாரதிய ஜனதா கட்சி சார்பாக இவருடைய மலிவான வணக்கம். அகில இந்திய பொதுச் செயலாளர், ராஜ்யசபாவுடைய உறுப்பினர், உத்தரப்பிரதேசத்தை பூர்வீகமாக கொண்டவர், கர்நாடக மாநிலம், குஜராத் மாநிலம் இரண்டு மாநிலத்தினுடைய பாரதிய ஜனதா கட்சியினுடைய பொறுப்பாளர், அகில இந்திய பொதுச் செயலாளர் திரு அருண் சிங்ஜி அவர்கள் தமிழகத்திற்கு மூன்று நாள் பயணமாக கட்சி பயணமாக வந்திருக்கிறார்கள். நேற்று முன்தினம் கோயம்புத்தூரில் ஆரம்பித்த அவருடைய கட்சி பணி நேற்று ஈரோடு திருப்பூர் எல்லாம் முடித்துவிட்டு காலையிலே திருப்பூர் முடித்துவிட்டு இப்போது கோயம்புத்தூர் தெற்கு தொகுதி அதனுடைய கூட்டத்திற்காக வந்திருக்கிறார்கள். இப்போது நம்முடைய பத்திரிகை நண்பர்களை சந்தித்து அவருடைய கருத்துக்களை பரிமாறுகிறோம். நன்றி, வணக்கம். அருண் சிங்ஜி அவர்களை பேசலாம்.
Good evening, all media friends. Yesterday was a very auspicious day when the India crossed Herculean task of 100 crore vaccination under the leadership of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. 5 crore 34 lakh vaccination is also there in the Tamil Nadu. You will be aware in India also and foreign institution also, they are appreciating the way the Prime Minister took the initiative since beginning and appreciating the and providing necessary assistance to the scientists. In April 2020, itself constituted a task force for the vaccination, which was looking impossible that India would be able to develop the vaccination against the COVID-19. But impossible task has become the possible under the leadership of Narendra Modi ji, with the hard work of the scientists day and night they have worked. UNO Secretary General has also appreciated the India role and India effort in this contest. Just now, 1 hour before also, Bill Gates has also said that India has registered 1 billion vaccine doses or testament to the India innovation ability or innovation ability, manufacture and scale the effort of millions of the health workers. He is also congratulated. Across the world, the congratulations we are receiving in the country. I am here for the last 3 days in the Tamil Nadu. I have been earlier also in Tamil Nadu. But this time I feel a different, a uniqueness. I could see the existence of the lotus everywhere, wherever I have been to, in the Coimbatore, in Tirupur, in the area also, Erode. Now the BJP workers, they are confident that, and they are working hard at the booth level, and party is emerging at the booth level under the leadership of K. Annamalai. He is working day and night very hard. Most of the district is covered already. And BJP under his leadership, the kind of hospitality, a warm reception extended to me. I thanks all the party workers, and I am also inspired by the rich culture and legacy of the Tamil Nadu. Every Indian have pride that one of the oldest language of this universe is the Tamil language, that is from this place, that is from India. Friends, now our growth story after the COVID is totally changed. So India has become a kind of a golden place, attractive place for the entire world to come and invest in India. Because of the transparency, because of the policy reforms, because of the governance issue. If you look at the last 4 months itself, the FDI, there has been 62% jump in the FDI as compared to the last 4 months of the last year. Forex reserve is the highest ever. That is highest ever forex reserve in India, $639 billion. That is a forex reserve here. The rating of India is also being improved. If you look at the October itself, Moody has improved India rating, financial risk rating. Earlier it was a negative, now it is stable. Standard & Poor's, another rating agency, they have also improved the India rating from negative to stable. This is the growth story of India started. Whether the IMF or World Bank, every institution, they are projecting that the India GDP will be between 9.5 to 10%, and we expect that it will be more also, because everyone is coming towards India. From China, they are diverting to the India. By announcing 100 lakh crore rupees for the infrastructure sector, 100 lakh crore rupees beyond imagination. What kind of infrastructure will be there, whether it is a road, port, railway, one can't imagine. India will take a lead in the world for the infrastructure creation. It will provide the huge employment also. In the, where I am sitting, Coimbatore itself, defense corridor has been announced. Two defense corridors, one in UP and one in Tamil Nadu, that is in Coimbatore. This reflects the Prime Minister's vision about the Tamil Nadu. If you look at the budget also, the 13th Finance Commission, when the UPA was in the power, the entire budget for the 13th Finance Commission was 81,000 crore. Now in the 14th Finance Commission, 1,80,000, from 81,000 crore to 1,80,000 crore. This is the allocation to the Tamil Nadu by the Union Government. In Jal Shakti Mission itself, because the Prime Minister has taken a place that each and every household should be provided with the tap water, drinking water with the tap water. That is the place he has taken. And the UPA and the Congress government, supported by DMK also, they have not done anything for the by ruling the 6 decades. Now this is Prime Minister who has taken the place that each and every individual should get, every household should get the tap water. And for that also, if you look at the 2020-21,